Hello friends, this is my first video and anatomy. Now we will discuss about the brachial plexus. Now first imagine as a tree. Tree is contained. Okay, trees contain roots. Roots, then trunk, then division, then cords and branches. Okay, the tree contains roots, then trunks, then division, then cords and branches. Like that, today's our brachial plexus is imagine all that structures. Okay, first of all, brachial plexus. Plexus means the connection of the nerves. That is the connection of nerves, and the brachial plexus is connection of the spinal nerves which supplies to the upper limb of the body. Okay, now first root. Okay, roots, that is C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. Okay, C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1, these are the spinal nerves, spinal cord, especially that is the ventral rana of the anterior one of the spinal cord, come from the C5 to T1. Okay, now these are the roots. Clear? Now C5 and C6, they join together. C5 and C6 are joined together. It forms the upper trunk. Okay. Now C7 is continuous as a middle trunk. Now C8 and T1, they togetherly form a lower trunk. Okay. Now upper trunk, middle trunk, and lower trunk. These are the parts. Clear? Now after that, each trunk is divided into the upper and lower division. Upper and lower division. Clear? Now, after that, upper division of the upper trunk and upper division of the middle trunk, they communicate with each other, they connected with each other and form a lateral cord. Clear? After that, upper division of the lower trunk is continuous as a medial cord. Clear? After that, remaining all divisions, they are togetherly connected with each other and form a posterior cord. Okay? The lateral cord, medial cord and the posterior cord. Now, branches of the brachial plexus. First, branches from the root. Root branches, that is C5, C6 and C7, from their root values gives a branch to the serratus anterior and known as the nerve to serratus anterior. Okay? Now, one branch to the phrenic nerve. And one branch to the dorsal scapular nerve, and one branch to the dorsal scapular nerve. Okay, so branches from the root, phrenic nerve branch, dorsal scapular nerve branch, and from the nerve to serratus anterior, along with also supply to the neck of muscle, that is the longus pollicis, along with the scalene muscles. Okay, now trunks. Only upper trunk gives two branches. That is, one is suprascapular nerve, and one is the nerve to subclavius. Nerve to subclavius. So only upper trunk gives two branches, suprascapular nerve and nerve to subclavius. Now branches from the cord. First, that is lateral cord. Lateral cord contains three branches, gives three branches, that is pneumonics, L, M, L. Now what is mean by the L, M, L? Okay, first, that is the lateral pectoral nerve, then musculocutaneous nerve and the lateral root of median nerve. Okay, lateral pectoral nerve, musculocutaneous nerve and the remaining nerve is what? The lateral root of median nerve. Okay, these are the elements for the lateral cord. Now turn to the branches from the medial cord. Its mnemonics is M for U. M for U. Okay. Now M, that is first name is medial cutaneous nerve of arm, medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. Okay. Now median pectoral nerve and a one branch to the formation of the median nerve, that is the median root of median nerve. It's from the median root of median nerve. Clear? And the symbol U is the ulnar nerve. Okay, so here median cord or median cord is the five branches, M for U, median nerve of arm, median cutaneous nerve of forearm, medial pectoral nerve, branch to the median nerve, formation, that is the medial root of median nerve, and formation important nerve, that is the ulnar nerve. This is the ulnar nerve. Now, branches from the posterior cord. The posterior cord mnemonics is the ulnar. Mnemonics is what? Ulnar. What is meant by the ulnar? Now, the ulnar, that is U. U means upper subscapular, L is lower subscapular, N is nerve to latissimus muscle dorsal, A is axillary nerve and R is the radial nerve. So U means upper subscapular, lower subscapular, nerve to latissimus muscle dorsal, axillary nerve and radial nerve. These are the branches from the posterior cord. Clear? Now, a point where six nerves are met with each other, C5-C6, then suprascapular nerve, then nerve to subclavius, upper and lower division of the upper trunks. This point is known as the Hub's point. This point is known as the Hub's point. If any injury, any paralysis in this region is due to the Hub's paralysis. Now, Hub's paralysis is what? That is the arm is get medial rotated and the adducted. Then forearm is extended and pronated and sometimes the wrist joint is get flexed, known as the policeman's stiffs or quarter stiffs. If T1 and CA, that is if any difficulty or any paralysis due to the club case paralysis. Now, nerve to serratus anterior. Nerve to serratus anterior is also known as the long thoracic nerve or nerve of bell. If any injury to this nerve is due to the winging of scapula and the winging of scapula means the medial border of scapula is elevated and that known as the winging of scapula. Okay, now overall of the brachial plexus summary. First is formation of the root C5, C6, C7, C8 and P1. Then C5 and C6 they form the upper trunk. C7 continues as a middle trunk. Then C8 and T1 continues as a lower trunk. Okay, now they are divided into the division. Okay, upper division of the upper trunk, upper division of the middle trunk, they form the lateral cord. Then upper division of the lower trunk continues as a median cord and lower division so is continuous as a posterior cord. Okay, now branches form the brachial plexus. Roots use the phrenic nerve, dorsal scapular nerve and nerve to serratus anterior. Upper trunk gives only branches, suprascapular nerve and nerve to subscapular. Then cords, lateral cord, lateral pectoral nerve, musculocutaneous nerve and the lateral root of median. Clear? Now median parts gives the median cutaneous nerve, arm, median cutaneous nerve, forearm, medial pectoral nerve, and communicating branch to the medial nerve, to the median nerves, and continuous as a ulnar. Now posterior cord gives upper subscapular nerve, lower subscapular nerve, nerve to latissimus dorsi, and radial nerve and the axial nerve. These are the branches of brachiopexis. Thank you very much. If you like my video, please like and subscribe.